Hello everyone, in this video we will try to know about Roshni Act or Roshni scam of Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory of India, or we can say erstwhile Jammu and Kashmir State of India. The year was 2001 when the Farooq Abdullah government came with a new law, namely the Jammu and Kashmir State Land Vesting of Ownership to Occupants Act. Let me tell you, Farooq Abdullah is a leader of National Conference Regional Party of JNK. So what was the purpose of that scheme? By this act, the government of Jammu and Kashmir decided to transfer the ownership rights of the land to the occupants. But for becoming the validate occupant of that land, the individual has to pay a fixed fee to the government, and that was decided by the government itself. Especially the cutoff date or encroachment date was fixed at 1990. It means individual who is living in a land from 1990, if he want to become the owner of that land, he need to pay some amount to the government and he will be the validate owner of that land. So in this process, from 2001 when the law came up to 2007, the most of the land was transferred to its occupants by charging a fixed fee by the government. So what was the plan of that act? The erstwhile Jammu and Kashmir state was having electricity crisis. In fact, the act was also referred as the Roshni Act. It means that time the government had planned to raise 25,000 crore rupees from this act. The intentions were to raise the electricity within their area and to provide the electricity to the citizens. But the intentions were not good. The government had planned to raise 25,000 crore, but it only raised actually 26 crore rupee only from regularization of 71,000 acres of land in Jammu and over 4,000 acres of land in Kashmir. Surely it was a big scam, a big land scam. This scam came into light in 2014 when Comptroller and Auditor General of India, CAG, first time raised a red flag in this regard. So who became the owner of that land? Under this scheme, the most of the legal ownership rights were given to the political leaders, influential peoples or their relatives, and just at a trivial prices. When the matter came into light, most of the occupants of that unauthorized land tried to sell their property. But in November 2018, the Jammu and Kashmir High Court restrained the occupants of the land, regularized under the Roshni Act especially, from selling or carrying out any kind of transaction over this unauthorized property. And in 2018, there was a coalition government between PDP and BJP, People's Democratic Party and Bharatiya Janata Party. In June 2018, the coalition failed and the erstwhile Jammu and Kashmir state came under Governor Mr. Satyapal Malik. So that time Mr. Satyapal Malik, as the chief administrator, repealed the Roshni Act and ordered a CBI inquiry into the scam. And the continuously progress happened in this case, and on October 9, 2020, the High Court of Jammu and Kashmir held the Roshni Act as unconstitutional, means null and void, and even directed the government to make the complete identities of influential peoples who grabbed the land under the regularization of that law. And on 1 November 2020, the Jammu and Kashmir government issued an order to cancel all land transferred that took place under the Roshni Act. In fact, recently the Jammu and Kashmir administration, the Union Territory Administration, released the first list of 868 names who illegally grabbed the land in Jammu and Kashmir under the part of Roshni scam. Surprisingly, the list included the names of former Chief Minister of the erstwhile state, Farooq Abdullah. Even the top regional politicians are in list, bureaucrats are in the list, and even the police officials. No doubt, this is the biggest land scam of Jammu and Kashmir. Indeed, when the High Court of Jammu and Kashmir held the Roshni Act as unconstitutional, Initially, the government accepted it, but later on filed a review petitions because the common people may be suffering from this move. We hope that the culprits will be punished and justice will prevail. That's all from my side. If you find this video informative, like it, share this video with your friends, subscribe this channel for more videos. Thanks for watching.